an NET Television production.
In the 1930s, the world turned dark with depression. On the Great Plains, it came with the prairie wind, sweeping the soil into the air, blotting out the sun. Men without jobs became drifters. Loren Eiseley was just 19 years old when he joined them.
The rest is almost forgotten with years. The grim, long windings through the Rockies, viewing the scenery from side doors or pulling a bandana over one's face and being careful to duck low in smoky tunnels. People dropped away as the mood or hunger struck them. Others ran and climbed aboard. It was a time of violence, a time of hate, a time of sharing, a time of hunger. It was all that every human generation believes it has encountered for the very first time in human history.
It looked as though, you know, Western civilization was perhaps coming to an end. Society was falling apart. There was nothing like the Great Depression before. What did he have to look forward to? And he saw a good deal of violence, and he saw an uncaring society. And I think it fueled this natural poetic urge, which was one of alienation to begin with.
It was the last of my drifting days, and if anyone were to ask what year it was, what month, what afternoon, I could not answer. I would be able to say only that it was for me the most perfect day in the world.
He was out in western Kansas amid the fall wheat harvest, and he had come to this railroad station, and they were waiting to jump a train. And there were three other fellows there. One is an Indian who was dispossessed. Another looked as though he might have seen the papyrus of ancient Egypt. Another's a freight car hopper who has the skills of a great boxer. And Eiseley is sipping grape soda with them. And the sun is out, and he doesn't have any worries at the time, so he projects them into the past and into an unknown future.
The town was small enough not to bother us, and out of some trifle of change, we bought great pop made by a factory in that very town. We drank it slowly with gusto and accounted it great, while we stretched in the shade beneath a water tank or lay dozing on the rough planks of the loading platform. I do not know whether we were headed west or east, or from what train we had dropped, or for what we waited. We were just there, birds of passage with no past, no future, no desires.